Democrat Tom Suozzi has officially defeated Mazi Pilip, a Republican, in a special election for George Santos's vacant congressional seat. Now, this is a congressional seat in Long Island. Long Island is not as blue, if you will, or as liberal as Manhattan is. And that's something to keep in mind as we get to more details about what Suozzi did in order to win this congressional seat. Now, first, some context into Suozzi, who he is, what he's done in his political past. He is, in fact, a career politician who served as mayor of Glen Cove, New York from 1994 to 2001. After that, he was the Nassau County Executive from 2002 to 2009. And then he served as the US Congressman out of New York's 3rd District from 2017 to 2022. Then he launched his failed gubernatorial campaign and decided after that failed campaign that he would run for this congressional seat that was left vacant by a liar, George Santos. Now, what's interesting about Suozzi's victory is how he campaigned. And he did so by leaning into the types of issues that progressives and Democrats generally want to run away from or refuse to acknowledge. So mainly he knew to expect some of the attacks and jabs from his political opponents in regard to immigration and crime. And so he decided to use that to his advantage. Suozzi made the migrant crisis a daily focus, along with cutting taxes, fighting crime, and protecting abortion rights. He called for Biden to temporarily close the southern border and sought to show voters that he too saw the problem and wanted it fixed. So in other words, he understood what the demographics were in the area that he was campaigning in the district he was attempting to win over. And so he really did present himself as more of a moderate Democrat as opposed to a firebrand progressive. And to be clear, I don't think someone campaigning as a firebrand progressive would do well in this district. I think that they would maybe have a chance if they stayed away from some of the cultural issues and instead leaned into economic policy. But that hasn't really been much of a focus in recent races, which is unfortunate. Now, Biden, by the way, in this particular district gets just 29% approval for his handling of the migrant issue. And Republicans have a 12-point advantage on which party would do a better job with it, according to the latest NPR poll. And I think it's really important to understand that while it is not in any way okay to be vicious or basically, I don't agree with some of the hardline anti-migrant policies, including some of which were included in the legislation in the Senate that was destroyed in the House because Trump doesn't want Republicans to pass any, you know, immigration reform that could potentially help Biden in the 2024 election. But with that said, when you look at the influx of migrants in certain parts of the country, namely these blue states and blue cities, the voters there tend to be part of the Democratic, you know, voting base, and they're frustrated. They're real frustrated. And so Suozzi knew that he needed to kind of lean into that frustration, acknowledge it, and respond to it in a way that would be appealing for these voters. When the Senate border compromise was released, by the way, Mazi Pilip publicly opposed it, and Suozzi pounced, saying, "Pilip points out there's a problem, a problem, a problem," Suozzi said during the race's only debate, but she has no solution. And according to CNN, that message did in fact resonate with voters.
From voters, that they were very, now these are obviously very well-informed voters, right, but they were at the polling station, they were voting early. And several of them said to me that they don't want to vote for the Republican because it's clearly impossible to get a solution on the issue of immigration. They said border, the border problem, the immigration issue, the migrant issue in their district was the top issue for them. And that the fact that Republicans killed that bipartisan deal put them over the edge to vote for Tom Suozzi.
We might have millions of people watching this show, but you can be the difference maker because we just need 1% of our audience to be paid members. And then this show can be around forever. So you can make that difference. Click join now.
Now, Suozzi has, I actually think he ran a smart campaign. Because again, you have to meet the voters where they're at. And if the migrant crisis is their top issue, then you do have to address that. But he also addressed other things that I would say progressives agree with, that typical liberal Democrats agree with. He said that he supported codifying Roe v. Wade into law. Do I think that's gonna happen? No, I don't. I think Congress is broken, but he at least provided the messaging to the voters there that they found appealing. And some of his views have also led to protests. So look, you guys just heard me say, I think he ran a smart campaign. And I say that as someone who deeply, deeply, deeply disagrees with him on the topic of Israel's war on Gaza, okay? I cover it almost every day on the show. You guys know how I feel about it, but nonetheless, he took a look at the demographics in this district, noticed that there is a massive Jewish voting bloc, about 11%. And so he stated that he is unequivocal in his support for Israel, even going so far as to say that he would have voted for a standalone Israel aid bill that, you know, failed to pass in Congress. Now, that's why his victory speech was protested, and I have to admit, I enjoyed this, but take a look. No justice, no peace, am I right? Jeez. Look, I like protest. I don't like watching a protester get pushed to the ground like that one did. And look, when you're protesting, obviously don't put yourself in a dangerous situation where you can get hurt. But I do think it's important for these politicians to hear what other voters are thinking when it comes to the unequivocal support that the US government has provided to Israel. Now, the Jewish Democratic Council of America estimates that this particular district, District 3 in New York, has one of the largest Jewish populations of anywhere in the country. That doesn't mean that every Jewish American is in favor of what's happening in Gaza. In fact, there have been many protesters of Jewish descent who are very much against and have taken part in protests in regard to what Israel's doing in Gaza. So I want to say that it's not as cut and dry, but I'm guessing they did enough work in figuring out where the hearts and minds of this massive voting bloc happened to be. And he decided to show his support for Israel, and it seemed to work out well for him for this election. Now, it's also worth noting that Pilip, meaning Mazi Pilip, the Republican, was massively outspent. So money played a role as well. Democrats spent nearly $14 million, almost double the GOP's $8 million investment in the race. According to Ad Impact, the total ad spend for just this Long Island district totaled an eye-watering, guys, $21.4 million for one congressional seat. That's more than quadruple the outlay of the 2022 race that yielded Santos. I mean, I guess you get what you pay for, right? Because Santos was a disaster. But look, I think that Democrats focused heavily on this race because they want to increase their numbers in the House. Republicans still have a very slim majority in the House of Representatives. But now that this seat has flipped from Santos, a Republican, to Suozzi, a Democrat, they are increasing their numbers, and I guess that money in their minds was well spent. So that's what happened during this race. I totally understand how some people are not in favor of this particular candidate. He's not left-wing enough for you. But remember, you're not necessarily in his district, and his district's voters might want something different from what you would want to see from your elected lawmakers in your district. And so this is how it plays out. You got to meet the voters where they are, and this is where they were.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member, and members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence, and that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.